Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and Adobe's just announced Photoshop CC 2018, the latest update to Photoshop CC. I've got five of my favorite features I'm going to show you right now. The first one is Lightroom Photos. If we click here inside the opening window of Photoshop, it will now sync with our Lightroom photos in the cloud. Now, there's been some big updates to Lightroom. Check that out on another tutorial. But I can actually go in here and I can view my photos that I've got synced on Lightroom and access them right here within Photoshop. So that's tip number one. Tip number two, let's open up this photograph inside of Photoshop, inside of Camera Raw. Okay, so what we can do is we can just adjust this. Let's get it where we want it, but we want to darken our background down again. Now we know we've got a quick select brush and we've been using this for a long time, but there's a new feature in here that I'm going to show you. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn on the mask and I'm just going to paint this quick selection right over the whole area. And normally that would be a recipe for disaster, but not in this case, because if we scroll down and we turn on auto mask, now we have a thing called range mask and we can go by color or luminance. We're gonna choose the color and this little eyedropper will be selected. And I can just click and drag to select that blue region right there. And notice that the motorcycle area now became deselected. You can also adjust this color range by tweaking it, see that? So we're just gonna turn the mask off now and just go back up to our brightness. And now we can turn our exposure down on the sky without losing it on the motorcycle. So that's tip number two. All right, feature three, an improved selector mask workspace, which is great. So let's just grab our quick select tool, make a selection quickly around our model. And then we go into selector mask. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna inverse the selection by clicking invert. And then we can use the transparency to pull it down a little bit. All right, let's show the edge right now. Pull up our radius. There we go, we've got our edge. Turn off show edge. Grab our tool here. And this algorithm has been improved that we're gonna get much better selections now. Especially in these hard-edged areas as well. Obviously it's looking good in the hair. Let's just go around the hair there, all the way around. Let's just get our edge there. That there is looking good, smart radius. And now turn on decontaminate colors, new layer for layer mask. But notice how much better this is looking, especially around these hard edges. In the recent one, these hard edges just really didn't look good. And now they are. And feature number four is intelligent scaling. So when we resize images to go much bigger, they can look a lot better now using preserved details too. So here we go, we've got the same picture. I've got it in two separate documents and then we're gonna resize it. So we're gonna take the first one. Let's double click, first of all, take it to 100%, same here. Double click there on the eyedropper. So you can see these are identical. Okay, so let's go select the first one and then we're gonna choose image and then we're gonna choose image size. We're gonna scale it by 300%. And if you didn't know, you could use percent right there. And we're going to use the automatic. Let's use that. Or we could actually, why don't we go to preserved details enlargement, which was actually the best that we had before. We click OK. And notice that's bigger. Now we're going to go to this one. And we're going to choose image size, 300%. And this time we're going to use preserved details too. So preserved details too actually uses machine learning or deep learning or artificial intelligence to actually recompose that photo. So let's have a look now. Let me hold down the H key, click and drag, and that's using our bird's eye to get in there and have a look. Okay, so we've got that. So why don't we have a look on the other one? So we're gonna choose window, arrange, and then we're just gonna choose match zoom and location. I'll match all, we'll do the same thing. All right, so here we go. We can see what we've done. The one on the left here is with the regular and the one on the right is with the new algorithm. So let's have a look at some details here. For example, look at the eye. See how much more detail there is in the eye versus that one? See how sharper there that hot spot is? And you can see these little sparkles there. Look at those compared to the other one. Even look on there. See how soft that particular one is versus that? So you can see now we're getting much better upscaling. And of course, and if we drop these down to fill the window, you probably won't see much of a difference at that magnification. But anyway, that's really huge. No pun intended. All right, new feature number 5, and possibly my favorite feature inside of Photoshop CC 2018, is the ability to work with 360-degree photos. So here's a photo taken by Russell Brown, and this is shot with a Ricoh Theta on top of his DJI Phantom drone. And this is actually in Wyoming, and we were there recently shooting the eclipse. So anyway, we now have the ability to work on this inside of Photoshop. So all we need to do is just go under the 3D menu, and then we go to Spherical Panorama and choose New Panorama from Selected Layer. And now this is going to turn it into an actual panorama that we can zoom around and we can see everything. There's Russell right there. Okay, so as we can see, the drone is in the shot, but what if we want to take the drone out of the shot? So let's take the field of view, and we're just going to drop this down to 1, just to the smallest. All right, so we're just going to make a selection around here. Let's just make a quick selection, and we're going to use Content-Aware Fill. So that's Shift Backspace, and that would be Shift-Delete on Mac, choose Content-Aware and Color Adaptation, and click OK. We're going to let it fill a little bit, and now, of course, we're just going to move this to get the rest of it. So let's make another selection over here. We could get rid of that hotspot in the sky too if we wanted, you know, the sun. All right, so that's going to be good enough for rock and roll. And now if we look at this, notice that the drone is gone, so people going around can look at this panorama. Now, obviously, you can spend time and get this absolutely perfect, and I'll do that in another tutorial. And then, of course, we could take this, we could export it out as a panorama that work in Facebook and stuff like that, and I'll show you that in another tutorial. Don't forget to check out the other tutorials I have a little bit more in depth on the new features here inside of Photoshop CC 2018. So anyway, if you like this, smash the like button into dust. If you like Photoshop and Lightroom tutorials, make sure you hit that subscribe button right now. And pound that notification button right there that looks like a little bell, and then you will never miss another one of my tutorials. Let's get a discussion going. Add a comment. What's your favorite feature? Are you excited about CC 2018? Do you love Photoshop? If you do, let me know. If you hate it, let me know. And so, guys, until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.